Bill Hearn, president of the South Dakota Trails Development Corporation, which puts on the Dakota 600. We are in the Black Hills, South Dakota, in Keystone, South Dakota, which is our headquarters and resort. The last 4 days have been a grand adventure. We had riders from 22 states come, and we rode anything from very, very difficult single track to really easy big bike stuff, gravel road pavements.
Oh, now there's no pressure at all.
What was probably your favorite part?
The water nymph.
I'm a freelance journalist in the motorcycle industry. I'm here doing a story about the Dakota 600 for Dirt Rider magazine, and we're also doing a story about the test ride of the Beta 300 RR.
I'm Rodney Smith. I'm a brand ambassador for Beta Motorcycle Company. I take care of press relations.
We need to redo your intro a little bit. Rodney Smith.
I can pop a bunch of stuff off. I'll just start scrolling. I'll write his CV out and just scroll it up the screen as you're talking, since you want to be humble about it.
Yeah.
I've done a few things on two wheels.
Yeah.
We'll put it that
way.
I've
had a good career.
Man, we hit it hard and fast. And to be honest, I wasn't sure about the level of difficulty coming into this event. I thought maybe it was just kind of more of a chill, dual sporty type thing. And I'm telling you, the second we turned off the highway onto these single track trails, I was like, oh boy, here we go. You know, I'm gonna have to get comfortable pretty fast. It was rocky, steep, switchbacks, roots. This place is no joke. There's some very serious single track here. It's very challenging.
My goal in starting the Dakota 600 is to leave the sport better than I found it. And the Dakota 600 really does two things. One, I wanted to create an extraordinarily good ride, and it is one of the better rides in the country. Show the people a wonderful adventure. And the other is to have a continuing funding source for our trail development work, so we can build more motorcycle trails, mostly on federal and state land. And it has achieved both those goals, and that's the purpose. Have a great time, raise money. Well, we run a small group, okay? There's only 50 people a year, and registrations will open in February. We get people from all over the country. It's a absolutely wonderful, wonderful group of people.
Bill looked at me and he's like, all right, I'm gonna let you guys go. Rachel, you can lead. So just leading some of these trails, it was so much fun. I was so happy.
This year is very drama-free. We didn't destroy a single motorcycle. And nobody got hurt.
There's a lot of really amazing moments this week. Moments that were amazing because they were challenging, and I felt like I did it when I thought I was at the end of my rope and couldn't go anymore, and we kept going, so that's always a great feeling. But today, day four, we decided to take it easy a little bit, but we did hit up some more single track and just got to do some fast sweeping stuff. And I had one of those moments that was just, this is why I do this. This is why I ride dirt bikes. It was just an outstanding day. It's such an outstanding week. America is so beautiful. Just to be here and kind of take in the beauty of the whole area as well. I mean, we spent most of our time in the woods on the single track, but got to do a little bit of sightseeing as well. It's hard to pinpoint one specific favorite moment. I mean, I had my favorite moments every day.
How does the Dakota 600 compare to other events?
I mean, most of us are faster than Bill anymore. I mean, he was faster than Bill. So you just go off and leave him when he gets there.
One of our riders thought he saw a big elk. And so he says, look over there to the left. Well, it's a Charlotte cow. But Bob swears that it was a big bull elk.
Treat you really, really well. It's high-class food, high-class lodging. We have 24 national sponsors. This year we gave out about $16,000 of goods to all of the riders, but the kindness of the group of riders that come here and the generosity of them is just really heartwarming, and that's my takeaway of what a wonderful group that I've been blessed to have come.
Bill's the best. Is it working?
Probably the most striking thing to me, many of the people that have come to this have come multiple years. We have, I think, six people have been all 7 years. And I don't think people would be coming back year after year if it wasn't an extraordinary event.
I've been to a lot of events like this and ridden all over, and this is probably the best group of people I've ever been riding with.
I think the best thing about events like this is just the people, and Bill is so great at bringing a good group together and coming up here for dinner every evening, and we all get to chat with each other and hear about everybody's rides and heckling each other and laughing. And
yeah, I only crashed once. Todd crashed 7 times.
That was really great. There's so many people. We've exchanged numbers and business cards and stuff and made some contacts here. And I really hope to be back with some more friends next year.
This is my first year, yes. My father's been about 3 years now, and he's just raved about the event every year when he comes back. And it's my first year, and I'll definitely be back.
Well, the other thing too, just the compliments that I got from the guys, it really meant a lot to me, and it kind of helped validate me to a degree, but I felt great about it, I will say.
The highlight, minus the riding, is just the people. The great team with the Dakota 600, I mean, from the moment we got here, help unload, help get everything ready. Everybody's there for each other, and whether it's on the trail and you need help with your bike, or at night helping each other, and just been a great time, and the people make it all the better. The riding's awesome, but the people make the event what it is.
Yes, and the joy of riding the Beta 300 RR.
Pulling in for the hop.
Well, my bike says 102.
When I do that Dakota dual sport, I ride with a guy named Robert, and he has no hair, but if he did, it'd be on fire.
Yeah, you about went in the ditch. Oh crap, oh crap, oh crap.
Chili. Edward's hot shots back here have a new technique that works.
Okay, so the gates are pretty steep at the start, and I jumped the gate all the way onto the gravel road.
ABS turns back on when I turn the bike off. I started down that second bit now, but I had a runaway.
Up this. Keep going, keep going. Well, you're gonna want to get a roll with this. Woo, baby. Woo, baby.
Across this little meadow, and I could tell there's maybe it possibly could be a little wet down in there. Grass was about this deep, and I'm going across there pretty cautious. All of a sudden, I could see it was dark. So I get across there, and I look back, and I just caught Doug crossing it, and he made it across. I look back, and I could see Rolf was there. I could see his bike, and he wasn't to the drainage yet. He was like parked right in front of it. But he was off the bike, and he was down in the drainage, and I could see him messing around, and then he would get up, and then he was back down again, and then he'd get up. Couldn't understand what he was doing, and I thought, well, where's Steve at? He should have been down there by now. Steve was laying upside down in the drainage, and I couldn't see him, and his boot was hooked on the radiator shroud.
Hey, Rolf, you forgot to say what Rolf was doing down there. You're trying to give me mouth.
Oh, yeah.
Water fairy crab.
I have to ask about what the hell.
No, it sounds like I'm a forest nip skinny dipping. I don't know. We went to the hot springs in that creek there, and I just took my boots off and rolled my pants about here. And Rick is, before that, he's like, Rachel, you can go down there and be a water fairy. And I was just like,
thankfully, there hasn't been really many ruts in the middle of this stuff. Oh, fuck.
Thank you.
go.
Chatty Cathy, say something.
It was a great time.
This is for you, Rick. I came, I saw, I rode, I conquered. I said it.